Alex, finally IBC again and EDIUS 11 is there. How have the reaction from the customers, from the EDIUS user base, how has it been?
Yeah, it's been great. It's great to be back to the show and finally to be able to show a new version of EDIUS right here. And yeah, we've been getting very good feedback from the customers, mostly positive, a lot of new requests. So hopefully we can continue to do more, but I'm hoping that, yeah, this will be a good launch.
Right. I mean, there's a big number of new features included, and we have a kind of a focus on AI technology. So we are using those easy to do things like getting rid of noise in audio recordings, or we have support for easy color correction. That's very useful, and it's going into a direction where we can say this is a big list of new features. You have it set. Of course, customers always want more features, and there is this integrated possibility to get more because of EDIUS 11. How does it work? What's happening?
Yes, for that purpose, we are introducing this new EDIUS Chorus Hub architecture, where it allows a central database server to allow share content information like metadata, markers, between multiple machines, multiple EDIUS machines, Minks, even other third-party applications, third-party services, to share share information and to be able to allow more functionalities, a better workflow within for the users.
Right, working connected. That is really a very nice feature. I mean, in the past, this was possible with some solutions from Grass Valley or others, but they were quite expensive. And now we have our own server solution from the EDIUS team, which is very much optimized for the EDIUS users. And I think interesting is that the possibility to connect not only like clients and Mink and EDIUS to that server, but also services. That is, it's very interesting because we tried it out here at the show, not just with the server version, but even with the individual EDIUS. On your EDIUS, you have automatically Mink and EDIUS installed, and they are sharing information, so they have already a database. Now, this database can be connected to services, and we tried it out here, and within just a day, we could search for like black frames by using some code, or we could automatically have a description of a scene, so some kind of auto tagging, and of course that makes it very easy to organize your own footage. And if you're working together, I mean, that's a game changer, because your server will get all this additional information from those services. And I think, I mean, other companies are doing the same, but they're integrating a service into their product. We are offering just like the possibility to connect any kind of additional service by adding an API structure. We are able to make a short description, or even deliver a complete solution to add those functionalities. And for those who are like system integrators, they can just for any kind of customer, they can build individual solutions with just a kind of standard code, right?
So let's have a closer look at these new possibilities. We would like to do a scene detection in EDIUS. EDIUS itself does not offer this function, but now we are able to use another tool externally. We send this service to a local application. The tool will detect scenes and send back markers. It is also possible to get a description for these scenes. We send single pictures from the video to the engine that describes them. Now we can search for content by using the scene description. The same could be done with audio via a speech-to-text function from another service. The name of a clip does not always reveal its content. Now AI can find specific content either on the base of how a scene is described or what is spoken in a video clip. These are just a few examples of what is possible with the new API structure.
I was really impressed to see how it's working and how easy and fast it's going. And it is a different approach. I think that many customers would say, like, I don't need this, I don't need database. And so, yes, you don't need database to work in a database, but you probably need all these features which suddenly are possible. I thought of, we have a media storage in the company where we put on a lot of files, and in the end, we never know where something is. So using the combination of a Chorus Hub server and auto-tagging, just that case, and then I can search for like a few words, and then I'll find all those clips. That's just amazing. So, yeah, sorry again for talking too much, but I was really happy seeing that. And I understood that your team has been working very hard on this structure, which is working in the background. And it's not a visible feature what jumps into your face, but it gives you so many possibilities in the future of EDIUS 11.
EDIUS 11 offers an AI-based voice recognition that allows you to eliminate even extreme noise better than ever before. This interview was taken after the announcement of EDIUS 11 at the IBC show. You can hear a lot of yelling, general noise, and even music in the background.
The target of this new EDIUS Hub architecture is to be able to open up the EDIUS project to other workflows, to other tools.
To clean the interview, we simply add the new Extract Dialogue EE filter on the audio clip. By choosing from the presets, we can reduce the noise, or in our case, eliminate it all with the AI Dialogue Cleaner Strong preset.
The target of this new EDIUS Hub architecture is to be able to open up the EDIUS project to other workflows, to other tools,
So this is the original interview.
The target of this new EDIUS Hub architecture is to be able to open up.
And this is the AI-based correction.
The target of this new EDIUS Hub architecture is to be able to open up.
Although the correction is done by a complex AI engine, the correction is instant and does not require rendering or special GPUs.
Thank you for watching. What AI tool would you like to use in EDIUS in the future? Please send us your suggestions in the comment section below. Thank you.